Of schools haven't gone back to class yet, but the idea of wearing a mask is already keeping education leaders and health departments busy. WDRB's Darby Bean explains what happened during a meeting with the Clark County Health Department and Greater Clark County Schools this morning. Darby.
Today was the first day of school for Greater Clark students. The district's policy is keeping masks optional. In a meeting today with health leaders, we're told that policy has not changed.
The buses pulled up to the front doors Wednesday morning as students walked inside for the first day of a new school year at Greater Clark County Schools. Inside the building, some students in masks, others not. The district's policy, keeping masks optional.
If the county or the state or the governor mandates that students wear masks again or staff within the building, you know, we're going to adjust accordingly. Right now, we want to give our parents the option.
Tuesday afternoon, the CDC announced a recommendation for universal indoor masking at K-12 schools for students, teachers, staff, and visitors, regardless of vaccination status. The very next day, on the first day of classes, Greater Clark school leaders met with the County Health Department and Health Officer Dr. Eric Yazel to discuss what this means for Southern Indiana.
Well, it was extremely important to us, the schools, everybody, that we have as smooth of a start to the fall semester as possible. And we anticipate we still will, but you know, there's obviously some discussions that need to be had on the safest and best way forward from here.
As of now, no changes made to the mask policy at Greater Clark. Yazel says there's a state health department meeting in the morning where he hopes to learn more information about this CDC recommendation.
I know everybody sees those guidelines and wants answers right away and understand that we want to make sure that we're making good, common sense, data-driven decisions. And sometimes that takes a little time to make sure we understand all the nuances of the data and things like that.
He says cases are ticking up in Clark County and there are confirmed cases of the Delta variant. Yazel is encouraging vaccinations for those 12 and up and says while decisions may change throughout the school year, he's hoping to keep things as consistent as possible.
We want to make sure that we have a process in place to where this isn't bouncing back and forth by the day or week on what our guidelines are and things like that.
Floyd County Health Officer Dr. Tom Harris tells me he's meeting with New Albany Floyd County Schools tomorrow afternoon to discuss the CDC recommendations. That district is also not requiring masks as of now and starts back next week. Darby Bean, WDRB News.